When I say he froze, I mean myself. Friend, cause I can't redeem myself. Bye.
Shalom, shalom. This is Elder Ayil coming back to you from One Nation, One Power. I'm coming to you today because the Holy Spirit once again has impressed it upon my heart to bring forth a little knowledge of how the Most High operates. I want to get right into this thing. Go with me to, let's start in Isaiah. Chapter 17 and verse 1. Isaiah chapter 17 and verse 1. And then we're going to go to Isaiah 46 and 10. Go with me right fast. The burden of Damascus. Behold, Damascus is taken away from being a city, and it shall be a ruinous heap. In Isaiah 17 and 1, the Most High spoke it. He declared that what would happen in Damascus thousands of years before it actually happened. We're going to go into our Bible and see when did the Most High declare this. Because this in Isaiah 17 and 1, he didn't just declare this out of the mouth of Isaiah. Are you with me? We're going to go through our Bible and I want you to take a look at Isaiah chapter 7, verse 17 and verse 1. Right before your eyes. Shalom. Now I want us to look at Isaiah 46 and 10. Isaiah 46 and 10. Now, this prophecy of Damascus being destroyed, you can chalk that one up. That prophecy is happening right now. Now, let's deal with Isaiah 46 and 10. And the Most High, let's start at verse 9. Remembering the former things of old, for I am God and there is none else. I'm going to read it just like it says. I am God and there is none like me. He said, there is none out there like me. Oh, come on out of here. The Most High said in verse 9, he said, my friend, there is none out there like me. Let me break that down for you. He says, no, my friend, Nostradamus is not like me. No, my friend, all of your procrastinators in the New Age movement is not like me. He's saying, no, my friend, those practicing Islam and though they have a book that has not one prophecy in it that can foretell what's going to happen thousands of years before it actually happened. He said, there's none like me. Hare Krishna is not like him. Matter of fact, Jeff is not like this God, because he is not this God. This God, in verse 10, is going to let you and me know his power, his omnipotent power. Watch this. Declaring the end from the beginning and from ancient times, the things that are not yet done. Oh, I got to read that again. This God, the Most High, higher, is letting us know that there's no other God like me. He said the Satan don't have this ability. As a matter of fact, let me break down the Satan for you. The Most High is so bad that before he cast the Satan out of the heavenly realm and in the earth in Genesis chapter 6. Some of you can argue with that if you want to. But over in Isaiah chapter 14, Satan out of his own mouth said that he would be like God. Are you hearing me? So the Most High, before he cast him out, had already revealed to him the master plan of redemption. Somebody hearing me out there? That Christ would come and redeem his people back to his God. So that explains that the Most High can declare the end from the beginning. So that explains why you find in Egypt the mother and the child. Come on out of here. That explains why you find over time different images of the mother and the child spoken of in the two Babylons by Alexander Hislop, because Satan said that when he came to the earth that he would be like God, meaning there should be a woman and a child represented on the earth before the coming of Christ. Are you with me? For all of you in Egyptology that can't understand why there was a mother and a child in the beginning, and then here come Christ in the New Testament, you thinking that because it was in Egypt first that what we're doing, what we follow in the day, is false. But I'm here today to let you know that proves that what we follow in the day is real, my friend, because the Satan came to the earth, knew the master plan of salvation and redemption for people, so he came forth with his own false salvation for the wicked. Oh, you better come on out of here. The Most High said, there's none like me. He said, I already declared to you what I was going to do to Damascus before it happened, and I'm going to break down today and show you what's going to happen over there next. The Most High says, I declare the end from the beginning and from the ancient times, the things that are not yet done, saying, my counsel shall stand and I will do all my pleasure. This is Isaiah 46 and 10. Let's look in this Isaiah 46 and 10 a little deeper. The Most High says he declares the end from the beginning. The Most High is saying, I already know what's going to happen on earth before it happened on earth. I already knew and I already know what's going to play out. Just like you watching a movie for the third time. and somebody coming up to you and saying they want to go see this movie, automatically you start telling them what's going to happen in the movie and the scenes of the movie. Then they tell you, stop. Don't tell me that. You're going to ruin the movie before I go and see it. Oh, come on out of here. That's the power of the Most High. Watch this. He said he declares the end from the beginning. Isn't that what he did with Moses over in the book of Jubilees? When he had Moses by his side for a season, if you go read the book of Jubilees, let me read a little bit out of there. Jubilees chapter 1. And Moses was on the mount 40 days and 40 nights. And God taught him the early and the latter history of the division of all the days. The Most High taught Moses the early and the latter history. Because when you go down and read further in the book of Jubilees, the Most High told Moses what our ancestors was going to do even before they did it. And when the Most High told Moses he was going to have to deliver us to the hands of the Gentiles, Moses broke down and began to plead with the Most High that whatever he do, please don't deliver us to the hands of the Gentiles, because he knew how they were going to treat us. He knew that they would shoot us down in the streets like dogs. He knew that they would choke us out on street corners like dogs. Are you hearing me? Moses knew how we would be treated once we were put into the hands of the Gentiles. So the Most High had told Moses what was going to happen with the 12 tribes of Israel before it actually even happened, declaring the end from the beginning in the Pseudepigrapha. Declaring the end from the beginning. Now, I want to read that one more time. Declaring the end from the beginning and from ancient times, the things that are not yet done. Stop right there. The things that are not yet done. Don't that sound like Romans, where is that? Romans, the book of Romans. For the children being not yet born, neither having done any good or evil, that the purpose of God might stand. So when you understand, for the children being not yet born, and the Most High said, I'm declaring the end from the beginning, he already hated Esau before Esau was even born. He already chose Jacob before Jacob was even born. Oh, come on out of here. So for all of those out there that want to talk about Jacob stealing Esau's blessing, the Most High already hated Esau before Esau was even born, because it's his job to declare the end from the beginning and from ancient times, the things that are not yet done, saying, my counsel shall stand and I will do all of my pleasure. So the Most High, my friends, had chosen you before you was even born. Before your mother and father ever crossed paths, the Most High knew they were going to cross paths to have you. Christ says, you have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and brung you out of the world. Oh, come on out of here. Everybody out there right now that is waking up to this raw truth of who the children of Israel really are and who the true Jews are, you were chosen before you were even born. Yes, that might be a little too deep for you out there, but the Most High says he declared the end from the beginning and the things that had not yet been done. My counsel shall stand. Now let's look in this wonderful book, the Apocrypha. 2 Esdras chapter 15 and verse number 20. Verse number 20 will explain, because the Most High has declared what he was going to do with all of the nations of the world. So now you don't have to sit back and turn on the lying Fox News, the lying CNN, the lying MSNBC, and the lying news propagandized in Babylon, period. Here go your news. Come on out of here. If I post anything, it's going to be events that have actually happened. I don't want to hear nothing about what's coming or what they're planning. I want to know what happened. Come on out of here. So in 2 Ezra chapter 15 and verse number 20. Now over in Joel chapter 3, the Most High promised that he was going to bring all of the nations of the earth down into the valley of Jehoshaphat to there plead for his people and to repay them the things that they have done unto us. Now, in 2 Ezra chapter 15 and verse 20, it will explain to us what's going to happen next. Let's begin. Behold, saith God, I will call together all the kings of the earth to reverence me, which are from the rising of the sun, from the south, and from the east, and Libanus, to turn themselves one against another and repay the things that they have done to them. Stop right there. 2 Ezra 15 and 20, the Most High just said that the reason I am now gathering all of the nations down into the valley of Jehoshaphat is to reverence me so that I can now repay them for what they have done to my chosen. Come on out of here. For what they have done in 70 AD by saying, raise it, the children of Edom, to the foundations thereof. I'm going to repay them for that. For repaying them for what they did during the 1619 slave trade. I'm going to repay them for what they did during the 14th century Arab slave trade. You see, my friend, the whole earth is about to come into the knowledge that they are about to be chastised, and they are being chastised for what they have done to the so-called African-American, for what they have done to the so-called Native American, for what they have done to the so-called Mexican, for what they have done to the so-called Puerto Rican, for what they have done to the so-called Filipinos, for what they have done to the so-called Samoans. All of that blood that has been shed by the heathen on the children of Israel, the whole world is about to be repaid for it. So you can continue to shoot us down, you will be repaid for it. You can continue to not give us justice in the court system, the Most High is bringing forth judgment right now. Come on out of here. I wonder how many lives have been lost in Damascus alone. I've been paying attention to how many Israelites are being killed in Babylon, and then a storm rolls in the south, and 10 heathen are taken out by a tornado. I've been watching here for the last year, the Most High moving on the earth after an Israelite is being put to death by a police officer or the system in Babylon. Open your eyes. There's a war going on. No, the Most High is not actually coming down from the heavens, but he visits the earth in storms. So he is counteracting what the heathen are doing. Come on out of here. They kill one of us, 10 of them must die. Oh, you better come on out of here. Right now, what's happening on the earth is an eye for an eye. Oh, you better come on out of here. Now, I'm going to re-show you Damascus. And when you look at these pictures of Damascus, so-called African-American, this is pictures of your ancient homeland. That's right. The people living in what they call Syria today is part of our ancient homeland. So when you see in those bombed out buildings, that's the Most High clearing out our land and preparing our land for our return. Come on out of here. That is what is actually going on right now. The Most High is about to clear our land. That's why Russia's over there. That's why he called all of the nations on earth to come on down into the valley. That's right. Because that's what they're really fighting over anyway. Is anybody hearing me? That's why they're really there anyway. Their whole intent is to keep us from getting back in our land. That's what this is all about. The Satan is using every nation on earth to try to keep us from getting back in our homeland. So they all been conjoined at the hip with this thing all of these years. From the time we landed in Babylon, they all nations, according to Psalms 83, have conspired together against us, a people that have no army, a people that has no navy, a people that don't have no Marines, a people that's not about going out there and starting no wars or no terrorism, a people that's out there right now caught up in materialism, caught up in Christmas and Easter, a people that's walking around blind as a bat, don't know who they are, don't want to know who they are, happy as heck worshiping the false image of Caesar Borgia, while they are asleep, their God is fighting for them. And they don't even know it. They don't have a clue that their God is clearing out their homeland. They don't have a clue that their God, according to Joel chapter 3, is turning the recompense upon the other nations for what happened during the transatlantic slave trade. Come on out of here. They don't have a clue of what happened during the transatlantic slave trade, but I'm Eldai Yeel. I'm not going to let it slip by. I'm going to put it right in your face. This is an actual picture of our ancestors, a dedication. Where is this at? In the Caribbean Sea, off the coast of Grenada, they did a dedication to their brothers, so-called Africans. We know they was Hebrew Israelites that was thrown overboard. An underwater dedication. So for all you so-called African Americans out there, because I heard there's a movement out there trying to deny what happened during the 1619 slave trade, there go pictures, that's right, of people putting together underwater how many of our ancestors was thrown overboard. Come on out of here. You can try to rewrite history, Amalek, but the Most High got it wrote down thousands of years before it even happened. See how futile that is? Let's continue to look at 2 Ezra 15. In verse 21, like as they do yet this day unto my chosen, so will I do also, and recompense in their bosom, thus says the Lord God, my right hand shall not spare the sinners, and my sword shall not cease over them that shed innocent blood upon the earth. My friend, this is right out of Joel chapter 3 and verse 2. So for everybody out there that tries to say that the Apocrypha don't belong in the Bible, you need to repent and get on your knees and seek the Most High. Because in 2 Ezra chapter 15, this is exactly what is being said over in Joel chapter 3. But in verse 20, the Most High said that he's going to turn them one against another. Come on out of here. That's exactly. Remember, he said, I'm the same yesterday and today and forever. He said, I don't change. That is exactly what happened during the days of King Jehoshaphat. When Jehoshaphat seen that he was surrounded by the armies of the heathen, he went into the sanctuary and got down on his knees before the Most High and inquired of the Most High what's going on. And he didn't have the power to deal with this enemy. And the Most High told Jehoshaphat that you need not to fight in this battle. That's right. But put the praises out, put Judah out front. And just praise me, just dance and sing and have a good time because I'm going to turn the enemy one against another. And he did that. He did that before. So that's what he's saying right now. This is what you're about to see in the Middle East. You in the Valley of Jehoshaphat. You're about to see the Most High turn them one against another. So you ain't supposed to be sitting at home crying. You ain't supposed to be sitting at home boo-hooing. You ain't supposed to be sitting at home crying over that little baby that washed up on the ocean shore. Come on out of here. I'm going to tell you the raw truth. The Most High told you in his word what he about to do. And what he about to do is bring forth major death. That's right. He's about to repay the nations for what they did. See, they didn't cry when they killed over 1 million of our ancestors in 70 AD. They rejoiced. They didn't cry over the 1619 Arab slave trade. They rejoiced. And after watching the video about what they did to us over there in Holland and what they still do in Holland every year, rejoicing, come on out of here. I'm here today to let you know that the Most High is about to repay the nations of the earth. That includes you, China. For conspiring against us. That's right. For conspiring against the children of Israel. I live up here. That's right. Right next to the reservation. Every time I go down there on that reservation and see the condition of my people, it hurts and burdens my heart. You see, I know something that most of you out there don't know, but I'm going to go ahead and give you this little advice for free. DNA has memory. That's right. DNA has memory. And you wondering why Esau hates Jacob so much? It's because they got that DNA memory in their bloodline. That satanic blood that's running through their veins and pumping in their heart. They got memory of what happened. They got memory of how we defeated them. That's right. They got memory of King David and how he destroyed. That's right. Thousands of them. Come on out of here. They got a memory that let me tell you that they don't want to let go of. That's why they're going down in flames. You hearing me? They have chosen to go down in flames. That's why Russia building another nuclear weapon. Come on out of here. Because it is in the Most High's heart. There shall be a visitation on the idols of Babylon. Come on out of here. The Most High is about to hit Babylon. Come on out of here. So hard and so heavy. And all of you sitting out there running around here buying Air Jordan and Nikes and Michael Jordans and all type of shoes. Let me tell you something. You're going to need them shoes to run. I pray that them shoes that cost you $200 on this pagan holiday, that they're going to give you flight abilities. Come on out of here. Because what's about to hit Babylon, there's going to be a lot of weeping. It's going to be a lot of mourning. But we that are the righteous, he says, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High, that secret place, is keeping his laws, statutes, and commandments. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in him will I trust. I will not trust in the images of Babylon. I will not trust, come on out of here, in the Baptist church. I will not trust in the Methodist church. I will not trust in the Pentecostal church. I will not trust in the Catholic church. I will not trust in the peeing in the bushes church. I'm going to trust in the shadow of the Most High or higher, because it is under his shadow that I shall receive protection. It is under his shadow that I shall receive guidance. It is under his shadow that I shall receive leadership. So I'm here today to let you know that all religions are going down, that the Most High has executed Isaiah 17 and 1. Damascus, our homeland, the land where Christ walked, the land where Christ preached, the land where Christ taught, the land where Christ cast out devils, is now a ruinous heap. And we're going on further because now the Most High is about to turn the nations of the earth one against another. Come on out of here. And no, they're not about to fight with their hands in this fight. Come on out of here. This is going to be nuclear. Come on out of here. Because the weapons of the Most High warfare, come on out of here, is not carnal. Come on out of here. I'm here today to let you know what the Most High about to bring to planet Earth. We ain't ready for it. Come on out of here. This is El Dai Yield for One Nation, One Power, keeping it real. He about to repay the nations for what they've done and what they continually do. They still plotting against us. And while they still plotting against us, the Most High is about to make moves against them. So no, I'm not going to shed a tear for all of the deaths that are about to happen. Come on out of here. This is the season for an eye for an eye. Come on out of here. That's the law of the Most High. You might say, oh, well, we can't, I don't know, we ain't going to do nothing. We can't fight against Esau. We don't have a military. We don't have an army. We not terrorists. We are law-abiding citizens. Are you hearing me? The Most High going to fight this fight. Come on out of here. He's a man of war. He promised. He wants this fight. This is it. This is the last fight out of all the eons of time. So you might as well make it the best. Huh? Come on out of here. Most High making this fight the best. Come on out of here. He wants the governments of the world right now to roll out their secret weapons. He wants you to roll out your secret weapons. Bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat because he is there going to deal with the nations for what they have done unto his chosen. So this is El Dai Yield for One Nation, One Power, letting you know the raw truth. Don't forget what happened to your ancestors. Hear me and hear me good, because the Most High have not forgotten. Be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a nation soweth, that shall it also reap. Come on out of here. We can go deeper into this word. Most High saying Judah gonna fight. Come on out of here. He's saying when we get in those spiritual bodies, we going to war. So I'm here today to let all you Israelites out there know, I'm talking to the men. You better get your woe spirit ready. Because the Most High saying, when he put us in that new body, that's right, there's a new race of human beings coming to the planet. That's right. That's right. A new race. That's right. Of the 12 tribes of Israel, 144,000. That's right. 12,000 from each tribe. There's a new race. That's right. They're going to have that supernatural body. They shall be the gods, the little gods of the planet Earth, operating under the big God, Big G. That's right. They shall fall on a sword and it shall not hurt them. Come on out of here. Can you imagine that movie Neo? 144,000 Neos coming. Better get ready, America. Come on out of here. Better get ready. When I say get ready, America, I'm talking to all you so-called African Americans out there that need to wake up from your sleep. You better wake up like yesterday. We're running out of time. The clock is ticking. Isaiah 17 and 1. I just showed you the footage from RT News. I let you know the Most High is not playing any games right now. The gloves have come off. This is El Dai Yield for One Nation, One Power. Letting all you Israelites out there know, stay strong. Fear them not that can destroy the body, but fear him that can destroy the body and soul and head. I'm here today to let you know. Continue in your word. Preachers, be instant in season and out of season. The Most High is the judge. He the one going to judge everybody. All I got to do is preach this word. Be instant in season and out of season. The judge of all the earth. The wrath of the Most High is being poured out according to scripture. Isaiah 17 and 1 in Damascus. Who next? Let's wait and see. Told you on that last video, Most High gonna start moving on the south. Come on out of here. in storms. That's right. Gonna be a lot of heathens starting to die in the South. Come on out of here. All of you out there that want to call us the word, call us the monkey word, get ready. Most High coming to see you next. Shalom.
When I say Hebrews, I mean myself. Friends, cause I can't redeem myself. Bye.
This is you and fire, and we sure.